fractions on a number line, and we have solved the exercise 7.2. Right. So today we are going to learn about the very interesting factor, equivalent fractions, and simplest form of a fraction. Okay. Yes. Let's see the equivalent fractions first. Okay. So equivalent fractions is observe these three figures. Yes. And write the fraction. Is the fraction of this lesser number. Figure is. This figure represents the fraction 1 by 2, and this figure represents the fraction 2 by 4, and the third figure represents the fraction 3 by 6. Means 1 by 2, 2 by 4, 3 by 6 represents the parts taken from the number of parts. Okay? Parts taken from the total number of parts. If we place the pictorial figure from one on the other, they are found to be equal. Right? So then the fractions are called as equivalent fractions. So these are equivalent fractions. They are said to be equal. Okay? Yes. Then let's see how to write the equivalent fractions. Yes. How these are equivalent to each other? Let's see here. Here I have taken 1 by 2, yes, which is equal to 2 by 4, right? Which is equal to 2 by 4. I said that these two fractions are equivalent, right? Let's see here. 2 can be written as 1 2 ja 2, and 4 can be written as 2 2 ja 4, right? Here 1 by 2, and here also 1 by 2. But here the given fraction is, the first fraction is multiplied and divided by the 2, right? So we will get the same fraction. Then let's say here 1 by 2, which is equals to 3 by 6, right? So 3 by 6 can be written as 3 is 1, 3 ja 3, and next 6 can be written as 2, 3 ja 6, right? Here there is a first fraction 1 by 2 and here 1 by 2, and the first fraction is multiplied and divided by the same number, right? So then we will get the equivalent fraction. By observing these problems, we can say that to find the equivalent fraction of a given fraction, so we have multiplied the numerator and the denominator of the given fraction by the same number. Okay, so let's see in another way, how to write the equivalent fraction? Okay, is observe the picture and write the fraction. Is in the 6 triangles, 4 triangles are shaded. Right? How can we write this here shaded part? That is 4 by 6. Right? So in the other picture, here the 6 triangles. So here also shaded. Here there are the 3 parts. In 3 parts there are the 2 triangles. They shaded the 2 parts. So, in the total parts 3, they shaded the 2 parts, right? If these two pictorial figures, one over the other, they are found to be equal, right? So, we can say that 4 by 6 is equivalent to 2 by 3. Yes. Can you say how it is possible? So, then how do we get this, say these two fractions are equivalent. Yes, let's say here. So 4 by 6, which is equals to 2 by 3, right? So if we divide 4 by 2 and 6 divide by 2, yes, what we get the quotient? 4 divided by 2 is 2. Means 2 ja 4, right? Then 2, 3 ja 6. So we will get the same fraction, right? So we can say that to find an equivalent fraction of a given fraction, so we have to divide the numerator and the denominator of the fraction by the same number, 4 by 6, so it is divisible by the 2, right? So if we divide this fraction by the 2, we will get the equivalent fraction 2 by 3, okay? Yes. Then let's see some of the examples how to write the equivalent fractions. Let's see the example. Find equivalent fractions of. If the first one is 2 by 5 with the numerator 6. So we have to write the the numerator 6. See here the numerator is 2. So here we have to write up to the 6. Right? So what we have to do? We have to multiply by the same number. Right? See here in the answer 2, 3, 6. Right? So we have to multiply by both numerator and denominator by 3. Okay, S multiply here 2 by 5 into 3 by 3, which is equals to 2 3 jump 6 divided by 5 3 jump 50. So what does it? Write the 2 by 5 with the numerator 6. Okay, so it is the equivalent fraction of 2 by 5 having the numerator 6. Okay, yes. So let's do the second one, 15 by 35 with the denominator 7. Yes, once you observe here, the denominator is 35, but we have to write the equivalent fraction having the denominator 7. Then what we have to do is yes, we have to divide here, right? So let's divide here, 35 divided by how much it is equals to 7? Yes, 7, how much is 35? 7 by 35, then divide by 5. Okay, yes, divide by both numerator and denominator by 5. Okay, yes, the equivalent fraction is 15 by 35, which is equals to 15 divided by 5, then 35 divided by 5. We will get 5 how much of 15? That is 3 jar. Then 5 how much is 35? That is 7. Yes, 3 by 7 is the equivalent fraction of 15 by 35. Okay? Yes. Is it clear? Yes, let's go to learn some of the interesting factor whether the given two fractions are equivalent or not. Okay?
Yes. An interesting fact. Let's now note the interesting fact about the equivalent fractions. For this, complete the given table. The first two rows have already been completed to you. Sorry. Okay. So then in the first column they are given the equivalent fractions and the product of the numerator of the first and the denominator of the second. The product of the numerator of the second and the denominator of the first. And the fourth column are the products equal. Okay, yes, here the one of the example they show 1 by 3 which is equals to 3 by 9. Okay, so here the product of first and the second denominator and the product of first denominator and the second numerator. Okay, yes, they are given here 9 is equals to 9. So these fractions are equal. In the second example also, the given fractions are equal. Let's try third example. 1 by 4 which is equals to 4 by 16. Okay, the product of the numerator of the first and the denominator of the second means 1 into 16 which is equals to 16. Right? Then the product of the second numerator and the first denominator, that is 4, 4 is 16. Right? Now you can see product of these two. So 16 is equals to 16. Then we can write the given two fractions are equal. Yes. Okay. Similarly, 2 by 3 which is equals to 10 by 15. Product of numerator of the first and the denominator of the second means 2 into 15. 2 15 ja 30. Okay, then the product of numerator of the second and the denominator of the first, that means 10 3 ja 30. Now you can see here both the product is equal, therefore the given fractions are equal. So we have to write yes. Okay, then the fifth question is 3 by 7 which is equals to 24 by 56. Then now we have to multiply the product of first numerator and the second denominator. 3 into 56 which is equals to multiply here 3 6 are 18, and carry 3 5s are 15, 15 plus 1, 16. Then next, product of numerator second and the denominator first. Okay, then 24 into 7. Multiply 4 7 ja or 7 4 ja 28 to carry 7 2 ja 14, 14 plus 2, 16. 168. Both the products are equal, therefore the given fractions are equal. Is it clear?
Simplest form of a fraction. You see, when the fraction is said to be a simplest or lowest form of a lowest form, if its numerator and the denominator has no common factor except one. Right? So if the fraction is said to be simplest form or it is in the lowest form, the fraction having the numerator and the denominator have no common factor except 1. Okay? If let's say the example 36 by 54, let's write the lowest form of this fraction, means simplest form of this fraction. So to find out the simplest form of this fraction, so we have to divide the numerator and the denominator by the same number. Okay, is see here 36 by 54. Yes, these two numbers are divisible by the same number. So which is the same number? Let's start by 2. Okay, is here there is a 6, it is divisible by 2. Here there is a in the unit place 4, it is divisible by 2. Okay, let's divide by the 2. Yes, here 36 by 54, which is divided by 2, which is equals to be get. So 2 how much are 36? Yes, that is 28 in the 36. Then 2 how much are 54? Yes, divide here 2 2 ja 4, remaining 1 2 7 ja 54. Okay, 2 27 ja 54. Yes, see here 18 and 27. Okay, so 18 and 27 are both the numbers which is divisible by the same number. Which is that number? Yes, we can see here 8 plus 1 is 9 and 2 plus 7 is 9. So both these numbers are divisible by 9, right? Yes, again divide here 18 by 27 divided by 9 by 9. Is 9 how much are 18? Yes, 9 2 is 18. Then 9 how much are 27? Yes, 9 3 is 27. Yes. Now you see here what is the 2 and 3. So here the 2 by 3 is a fraction. So these two numerator and the denominator are not divisible by the same number. Right? Means these two numbers having only common factor as 1. Right? So 2 by 3 is the simplest form of 36 by 54. And simplest form is the equivalent to the given fraction. Okay, is it clear? Yes, once you see here 36 by 54 is a given fraction. To find out the simplest form of the fraction, we have to divide the numerator and the denominator by the same number. Okay, so after the at last the fraction, the numerator and denominator having the only one as a common factor, until that we have to divide the numerator, until we have to divide the fraction. Okay, so after we get the lowest form, means the numerator and denominator having only one as a common factor, then that is the lowest form of the given fraction. Okay, is it clear? Yes, let's take another example. Yes, okay. Yes, see here, to find out the lowest form of this fraction, once you see here, in the ones place there is a 2, in the 28 ones place there is a 8. So these two, numerator and denominator, divide by 2. Right? Yes, first divide by the 2. 42 divided by 28. So divided by 2 here. Okay, so what we get here? 2 how much are 42? Yes, 2 2 ja 4, then 2 1 ja 2. Right? Then 2 1s are 2, then 2 how much are 8? 2 4s are 8. Yes, now you see here 21 by 14. Yes, see here 21 and 14 are divisible by which number? Yes, that is 7 number, right? Yes, again divide by the 21 and 14 by 7. Okay? Yes, both the numerator and denominator divided by 7. Yes, 7 how much is 21? 7 3 is 21. 7 how much is 14? Yes, 7 2 is 14. As you can see here, 3 and 2 are not divisible by the same number. They have a common factor only 1. Okay? In other way also you can find out the HCF. How means? So just we have to find out the HCF of 42 and 28. Then we can directly divide by that number. We will get the lowest form. You see here, what is that? The third example, 50 and 75. Is what is the HCF of 15 and 75? Let's find out here HCF of 15 and here 15 and 75. Okay. Is 3 5 are 50, right? Here 3 2 are 6, remain 3 5 are 50, right? 25 is not divisible, then I can take 5. 5 5 are 25. Okay. You see here what is the common here? 3 into 5, then 3 into 5 into 5. So see here 3 is common in both the numbers. So 3 5 are 15. So 15 is the HCF of both the numbers, right? So we have to divide by 15. So what we get at last? 15 how much are 15? 15 1 are 15. 15 how much are 75? 15 5 are 75. So what is the simplest form of this given fraction? Is 1 by 5. Okay, all else you can also cancel the numbers. Okay, it is about the simplest form of a fraction. Okay, yes, in this class we have learned how to write down the equivalent fractions of a given number and how to check the equivalent fraction, the given two fractions are equivalent or not, and we have learned simplest form of a fraction. Then how to write down the fraction into a simplest or lowest form. Okay, in the next class we are going to solve the exercise 7.3. Thank you.